beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. One word from God can change your life forever. Welcome to Life in the Word with Pastor Chuks Ozabon.
We are now in union with Christ. We have His life and His nature, enabling us to live like Him. Your life will not be a testimony. It'll be a testimony to the fact that Jesus died and rose again. It'll be a testimony to the fact that the curse is broken, the curse is defeated, and the blessing is operational. It'll be a testimony to the fact that we are not of this world. It'll be a testimony to the fact that our God is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all we could ever ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us. As long as you keep your heart in agreement with the Word of God and keep your speech in line with Scriptures, when your dream looks hopeless, what to do when all your friends exit your life and every door you can see has closed, what do you do? Glory to God. Remember our scripture, one of our favorite scriptures in Grace House, Psalm 5 verse 12. It said, "For thou, Lord, wilt bless the righteous, and with favor shall that compass him as with a shield." Hear me, you are blessed. Glory to God. Say it, I am blessed. Amen. Anything missing in your life, the blessing will fix it. You just got to be conscious of the fact that you are blessed. Blessed beyond every curse. And you got to say it. Praise Jesus. Now make the following statements. Are you ready? Say it with boldness. Say it with me, Father, I thank you because I am the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. And my prayers avail much. They are proof producing, supernaturally effective, dynamic in working, and powerful because I am blessed. The words that I speak are filled with faith and expectation. They are life and health to my body, and my words always come to pass and bring me victory because I speak the word of God. Therefore, I declare that by His stripes I am healed, never to be sick again. And every organ in my body functions in the perfection in which God created them to function, in the name of Jesus. I boldly declare that I am richly blessed, empowered to prosper exceedingly. I am fruitful, successful, progressive, creative in my thinking, abundantly supplied, highly favored, preferred above all others, and deeply loved. Indeed, I prosper and I enjoy sound health, even as my soul prospers, and I grow in grace and in the knowledge of the Lord. Thank you, Father, because you are able to make all grace, every favor, and earthly blessing come to me, Chukumozabo, in abundance, so that I, having all sufficiency in all things, I abound unto every good work, in the name of Jesus. I am an abounding believer. In my life, nothing missing, nothing broken, no shortage, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, because I am perfectly united with Jesus Christ, the anointed one, and all His anointing. And as a result, all the events in my life only reflect the beauty, the royalty, the dignity, the prosperity, the wholeness, and excellence of Jesus. He is the vine, and I am the fruitful branch, in the name of Jesus. I have abundant life, and this dynamic, excessive life of God in me now overpowers any seed of sickness or bondage in my body, in the name of Jesus. I decree that I'm anointed with uncommon favor because I'm clothed with the blessing of Abraham. As a result, I am unstoppable and irresistible. Therefore, doors that close against other people will open for me. Say it again. Doors that close against other people will open for me of their own accord in the name of Jesus, because I come in the name of the Lord. Scripture says, blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. I come in the name of Jesus. God's anointing, through which divine favor flows, is upon me now. I receive divine speed to possess uncommon results in record time. And I pursue, I overtake, and I recover all that the enemy stole from me in the name of Jesus. I am blessed to walk in dominion over all of life. Therefore, I declare that my words have the effect of fire upon any situation I address. Because according to Hebrews chapter 1, verse 7, I am a flame of fire. Therefore, I command and I declare that nothing shall ever be impossible to me. And as I speak, let the fire, say, let the fire in the word of God locate any problem or negative situation or complication designed to mock my redemption. Wherever you are and wherever you are, catch fire and perish now in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, because I believe I receive a manifestation of my faith in Jesus' name. If you receive that, shout hallelujah. Glory to God. Ladies and gentlemen, your excellencies, I want to announce to you that it's a month of testimonies. A month of testimonies. Hallelujah. I would ask that you believe. Dare to take your eyes off the negative circumstances trying to make you look like a failure and live like a slave. Look to the word. Look to the word. It's a month of testimonies. Hallelujah. Hosea 2:15 in the New Living Translation. The Bible says, I will return her vineyards to her and transform the valley of trouble into a gateway of hope. That word is for someone here this morning. You've done all you know to do. You've prayed. You've prophesied. You've gone for prayers. They've agreed with you. Things appear not to shift. I have a word for you this morning. God is saying, hallelujah. He is saying that he's giving you, or he's going to turn that valley of trouble into a door of hope. That situation today in Jesus' name becomes a stepping stone to your greatest season in life. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Glory to God. Good friends, don't be surprised by the opposition or the challenges surrounding you now. It all means that you are closer to your turnaround. Hallelujah. It means that you are close to your turnaround. You are close to seeing unexpected blessings. Some strange turnarounds. Right now, going on in the realm of the spirit, there is crazy wealth transfer happening. All you need to do is believe. Say with me, I believe and I receive it. Say it again, I believe and I receive it. Glory to Jesus. I'll be speaking to us this morning briefly about what I've titled, What to Do When You Are Challenged. What to do when your dream looks hopeless. What to do when all your friends exit your life and every door you can see has closed. What do you do when you are challenged? Our Lord, we ask that you will breathe upon your word uniquely this morning. Let your word bear fruit. And let everyone here today go back with a miracle. In Jesus' name we pray. What do you do when you are challenged? Hallelujah. First of all, understand that challenges are real to life. Any life without challenges is a life without purpose. You never see hijackers or armed robbers break into an empty house. No. They only break into a house with value. So any life without challenges is a life without purpose. So if you are challenged, that means you are going somewhere. The enemy has sent the glory around you. Somebody said, thank you, Jesus. So the reality is this. Challenges are real to life. But even more real is our redemption and our victory in Jesus Christ. Even more real is our perfect redemption and victory in Christ Jesus. Our faith is still the victory. 1 John 5:4. God's word says that whatsoever is born of God overcometh the world. And this is the victory that conquers the world, even our faith. Somebody say, thank you, Jesus. As long as you are in faith, the enemy can throw his best shot at you and still remain a loser. As long as you keep your heart in agreement with the word of God and keep your speech in line with scriptures, the enemy can throw his best shot at you and still come at a loser. As long as your thoughts and the choice of your words are in agreement with the new covenant, you never really fail. You only learn lessons. Somebody say, thank you, Jesus. Hear me. There is nothing the enemy can throw at you that is bigger than your faith. Religion won't tell you this, but the scripture says so. Ephesians 6:16. God's word says, above all, taking the shield of faith. Hallelujah. Can I have it on the screen? It says, above all. First of all, stop there. Above all. That means faith is above medical science. Faith is above biology. Faith is above IVF. Faith is above whether you have a CV or not. Faith is above all. Faith is above natural economies. Faith is above time. Faith is bigger than your past. Above all. Taking the shield of faith, wherewith you shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. This tells you there is nothing the enemy can throw at you that is bigger than your faith. And then again, there is nothing the enemy has done or can do that your faith cannot reverse. Your faith is still the victory. Praise Jesus. And God's word now tells us in 1 Timothy 6. Verse 12, it says, fight the good fight of faith. Lay hold on eternal life, whereunto thou art also called and hast professed a good profession before many witnesses. Fight the good fight of faith. Tells you, good people, that you've been called into a fight. Hallelujah. You've been called into what? A fight. The fight of faith is the only way to lay hold on what eternal life has in store for you. In other words, you only access the treasures of your redemption if you are willing to fight for them. Hallelujah. Not fighting the devil, but fighting past disappointments, fighting past dismay, fighting past guilt, fighting past discouragement, fighting past the setbacks you've seen when friends stab you in the back. You fight past all that to your wealthy place. Glory to Jesus. The fight of faith is the only way to lay hold upon what redemption has in store for you. Faith is the master key to a world of victory. And it's an unstoppable force, because it draws from the omnipotence and the integrity of God. Faith cannot fail. Hallelujah to Jesus. The fight of faith is a strange fight, however, because we fight from a position of victory. We have faith from a perspective of victory. We fight from our place in Christ. We don't fight on equal footing with the enemy, but we are seated in heavenly places in Christ Jesus, looking down at a defeated foe. When we pray, we don't pray for victory. We pray from victory. When we prophesy, we don't prophesy for victory. We prophesy from victory. We have the victory. Hallelujah. What is the fight of faith? The fight of faith is holding us real and calling real your harvests, your twins, your victories, your healing, your promotion, your fruit of the womb. Even when medical science says no and you don't feel so, but you hold it as real and you call it real. Somebody say, thank you, Jesus. The fight of faith is calling real that which you do not see as at yet. It might not be obvious to the natural eyes, but you know it is there. Faith is a conviction of unseen realities. Somebody say, thank you, Jesus. You know it is there because you've seen it in the world. I give you an imperfect example how conviction works. You know it is there. Let's say for the sake of storytelling, some of you that use these GSM cell phones. Now, I know my wife's phone number off heart. Now, she calls me a minute ago. We talked briefly, and I want her to buy me some ice cream or some Woolworth chicken or some egusi soup or something like that. And then I said, no, add some bushmeat. Let me call her back. And then you dial the number. MTN says, this number does not exist. You look and say, it's a lie. I know it exists. Why? You know it. That is conviction. Amen? No devil can confuse you about your own wife's phone number. Why? You already know it. That is conviction. So even if MTN or Vodacom or Glow or Cell C says this number does not exist, you are lying. You just switch off the phone, switch it on again because you know it is there. Faith is a conviction. Why do you keep dialing it? You are convinced. That is how faith works. You've seen it in the word that you are blessed. He said, be fruitful, multiply, replenish the earth, subdue it and have dominion. You've already seen it, that whatsoever he laid his hands upon to do shall prosper. You've already seen it, that Jesus was wounded for my transgressions. He was bruised for my iniquities. The chastisement that secured my peace was upon him, and with his stripes I am healed. You've already seen it, that you are blessed and highly favored. So you are convinced of the reality of your redemption. No devil can confuse you. Even if the circumstances look negative, you stand with the truth. Why? You are convinced. Faith is a conviction. Help me tell you about faith. It's a conviction. Hallelujah. It is a conviction. That the fight of faith is calling real that which you do not see as at yet. It might not be obvious to the natural eyes, but you know it is there. You know you have it because the word says so. Let me say this quickly, friends. From today, engage life with a victory consciousness. Engage life with the understanding that there is no way I can lose. It's impossible for me to lose. It's impossible for me to stay broke or stay sick. Engage life with a victory consciousness, a superiority mentality. Somebody say, thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Why is it so, you will ask me? In John 19:30, Jesus says, it is finished. Now, this speaks of a once and for all event, never to be repeated. It is finished. It stands finished. It will always be finished. The devil is defeated. The curse is broken. The blessing is deposited. We are made righteous. Our sins, past, present, and future, are forgiven forever. It is finished. Healing has been purchased. We've been made rich, blessed beyond every curse. It is finished. We are delivered. We are not going to be delivered. We are delivered. Amen. It is finished speaks of what? A once and for all event, never to be repeated. Jesus does not have to go to the cross again. The covenant is in force. Each time you wake up in the morning and you see the sun shining, you know the covenant is in force, and then it's to your advantage. The blessing is in place. Praise God. All you need to do is stand your ground on the word of God and fight. Fight in your thinking. Fight with the words of your mouth that it is as God said it is. Somebody say, thank you, Jesus. One would ask me now, but Pastor, why do we still need to fight if the victory is already there? You fight to walk in what belongs to you already. Amen. Somebody say, thank you, Jesus. Amen. Understand, all your harvests, all your miracles, all your victories already exist in the unseen realm. Faith makes the transfer. Faith is the bridge between the natural and the supernatural. Faith makes the transfer. All you will ever need already exists. You access your redemption or the treasures of your redemption through faith. Somebody say, thank you, Jesus. A perfect example, Deuteronomy 2:24. Let's read it together. This is God speaking to Moses and Israel. He says, rise ye up, take your journey, and pass over the river Arnon. Behold, I have given into thine hand Sihon, the Amorite king of Heshbon, and his land. Praise God. Begin to possess it and contend with him in battle. Notice God says he has given. Glory to Jesus. He has given. Hallelujah. Just as he has given us all things that pertain to life and godliness. God now says, begin to possess it and contend with the opposition in battle. Otherwise, you will never possess it. So the size of your position, the strength of your position is immaterial. God has given. Victory has been won. Your responsibility is to take God at his word and possess your inheritance. Somebody say, thank you, Jesus. Beloved, you must know this and know it very well. Know it very, very well. You have an adversary called the devil that hates you with a perfect hatred. He's against anything that has to do with your welfare. And even if he's a defeated foe, he will still challenge your progress because he's an outlaw. Praise Jesus. The enemy always tries to stand in the way of your promotion, even though he knows he will fail. But he will still try. This scripture, 1 Corinthians 16:9, the Bible says, for a great and effectual door is opened unto me, and there are many adversaries. Can I pray over you? Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, I bring the word of blessing over this assembly this morning. We take authority over every adversary standing between you and your breakthrough. We cast them down. We throw them down. Whatever is set in motion to deny you your due miracles this month, we come. Command them to crash land and catch fire in the name of the Lord Jesus. Even if he knows he will fail, he will still try. So write this down if you can. The child of God must be prepared to engage spiritual warfare in order to possess his possessions. I've said again, you must be prepared. You see, depression is a luxury you can't afford. He said, I'm discouraged. No, it's a luxury. You can't afford it. Somebody say, thank you, Jesus. The child of God must be prepared to engage spiritual warfare in order to possess his possessions. You see, it's impossible to access your own promised land that flows with milk and honey without standing up to fight. Nobody sits down and wins a race. Hallelujah. You gotta fight with the word. You gotta fight in prayer. You gotta fight by renewing your mind. Good friends, to live in victory, there is no room for self-pity. Please write this down. There is no room for self-pity. No room for depression. Stand on the word and take what is yours by the force of faith. Hear me? You are either ready to confront your position or the source of the shame in your life, or you remain in the same position. Can I say it again? Success is a choice. Prosperity is a choice. You are either ready to confront the source of shame in your life, to confront that issue that mocks your redemption, or you remain in the same position. There is no room for self-pity. Destiny is personal. What am I trying to tell you? You have a choice. Either you accept things the way they are and continue to manage life. Stay on the highway side of life begging every day, or you stand up and go and take what is mine. I'm coming for everything they said I could not have. You gotta stand and fight the fight of faith. Say with me, Pastor, we hear you. Hallelujah to Jesus. 1 Timothy chapter 1 verse 18. Paul the apostle says, this charge I commit unto thee, son Timothy, according to the prophecies which went before on thee, that thou by them mightest war a good warfare. That means use the word to fight. Everything I'm saying today from scriptures, use it as a weapon. Pastor said I'll never be broke again. So poverty, what are you doing around me? Pastor said I'll never be sick again. I'm not drinking this tablet again. Use the word to fight. The day the Lord has made, I will rejoice and I'll be glad in it. Your greatness will no longer be hidden. In the name of the Lord Jesus.